Hi everyone, I'm Liz Brown Swanson and welcome to Around the Peninsula. Now we hope this show will grab your attention because we're going to focus on the growing number of adults that have difficulty paying attention because they have ADD, attention deficit disorder, or ADHD, and there's no better person to talk about this with from the Peninsula than the RPV resident with me now. She is, calls herself Miss ADD.
That's right.
And you are a marriage family therapist, you are a life coach, you are an author, and you've been dealing with folks with ADD for decades.
20 years, yes.
And so why don't we just start with you sharing your story, how you're Miss ADD.
Okay, I'd love to. So I recognize now, looking back, that my childhood was very difficult in terms of school and making friends. And as I got older into adolescent years and young adults, a lot of difficulty with emotional regulation, being able to regulate my emotions, being able to focus on things. College was a disaster, almost failed out, but I really did actually the last year make it through, which was wonderful. And I could never, looking back, I could never really figure this out because I always saw myself as being a very intelligent person, but I saw everybody else around me moving forward, and I just wasn't. I wasn't really putting one foot in front of the other. So I was blessed with two boys, Chris, who's my oldest boy, who's 26 right now, and Mike, who's 23. And when they were young, Chris was diagnosed when he was 9 years old, and all of a sudden in his diagnosis, I started to see a lot of behaviors that I had when I was younger. And so I went on and also got diagnosed. And I was living in South Jersey at the time. I'm from New York, as everybody can hear from my accent. And I was working with a gentleman there who, he had a company that worked with behavior issues with children with ADD and on the autistic spectrum. And so he brought me in because I had a business background to help him run his company. And I started to really engage with the children, and he saw that I had kind of a natural way of being able to identify with kids and adolescents. So he helped me to become a coach, an ADD coach. And the reason I called myself Miss ADD.
But you're really Justine Ruotolo.
I'm really Justine Ruotolo, is because what I realized was that the kids loved that. When I had my email address as Miss ADD, they were all excited, and I wanted them to understand that, you know, this was something that they could be excited about because, you know, I saw all the creative side of these children. Did they have negative symptoms? Yes, absolutely. Are there co-occurring disorders with ADD? Yes, there's depression and anxiety, and you can have bipolar disorder, and, you know, there's a number of different things that can happen. But ADD in itself and being in control of those negative symptoms. And that's what happened to me. So about 5 years ago, I had something happen to me that was extremely traumatic. And what I recognized was that I really needed to do some hard work on myself. I saw a lot of my symptoms that were interfering in my everyday life, even being a coach, but I wasn't coaching adults at the time, just children and adolescents and working with parents. And so in this work, what I found was mindfulness. I really discovered mindfulness. And for those of you who are watching who don't really understand that, mindfulness is all about staying in the moment. When we run to the future, it causes anxiety. When we go to the past, it causes depression. But in the moment, for me and for a lot of people, because this is actually an evidence-based therapy, at this point, there's focus because there's peace and there's harmony. So when Carolyn Kelly, who is the chairman of the board at CHAD, Children and Adults with ADD, asked me if I would be willing to run a support group, I was very excited about sharing my story and my growth with other adults. And that was 4 years ago. And I am in control of my negative symptoms. I am on time. I'm not a procrastinator anymore. I have really pretty good focus. There are still times when I may lose something because that's part of what happens with us. But for the most part, I'm a pretty healthy and happy adult having ADD. And my fear is released because of all the work I did. And my creative side has come out dramatically. So
wow. We are here at the Center for Learning Unlimited in Torrance, which is right at the corner of PCH and Crenshaw. You run a support group here. We're going to talk a lot more about that work and how you are helping people and helping people deal with ADD. Talk about what those symptoms are. The symptoms vary.
Yes, they do. For a lot of people, they do. So in the world of ADHD, which is attention deficit hyperactivity disorder, you will see adults will see that they can't really attend. They can't sit still. They have a hard time with a lot of focus. They also are very impulsive. That comes with the ADHD. So impulsivity can either be in things that we say without thinking or things that we do without thinking. A lot of those people are seekers of adventure. So they like to ride motorcycles. And so relationships can be very difficult for adults with ADD. Communication is something that I work on not only in the group but with my individual clients because it's a strength of mine. Just helping people to communicate, I like to say, assertively and kind. Communication is difficult because we've heard a lot of criticism in our life. So the minute we think that somebody's being critical, then we can go up and then the conversation is over.
I was going to have you talk a little about the negative stereotypes that are attached to someone that has ADD, ADHD, or just the myths out there.
Right. So the stereotypes are we lose things all the time, we're late all the time, we can't focus, we can't sit still, you know, we can't talk in, you know, one thing after another. A lot of people with ADD tend to go off on tangents when they're speaking. So they'll start off on one topic and then end up on something else. And some of the myths that are out there is that this is not a medical disorder, and it is. It's a neurobiological disorder. And so a lot of people will say, oh, ADD doesn't really exist, but it really does, and it's a physical ailment, and you get diagnosed by a doctor.
So it's a brain-based disorder.
Absolutely.
And it tends to be run in families. It's genetic.
Yes. It can be very genetic.
And
yes.
It feels like everybody has it.
Yes.
I don't know. I have that feeling now that it's always like, oh, it's my ADD kicking in when you have a hard time, you know, when whether you know we live in a crazy world, and I think would it tend to feed off chaos?
Yes. Oh, absolutely it does. Yeah. And, you know, one of the reasons that I decided, again, to run this group is because I understood that I also fed off chaos and drama. Drama is something that's very big in this population. But in being able to understand more about how to get in control of the negative symptoms, I now run from drama. And I have just as happy and peaceful life as ever without the drama.
It is a challenge to have peace of mind.
Yes.
And we work on that.
Yes.
I'm curious on your views on medications. And, I mean, you're teaching mindfulness and skills that don't require medications, but when do you, you know, some people need it.
So when I work with parents and they have children and they come in and they're very concerned, I am not a psychiatrist, so I can't, you know, I can't medicate. But what I do tell the parents, and I tell adults the same thing, when you feel like your self-esteem or your child's self-esteem is really suffering, that they're not able to socialize in school at all. And I think socialization for children is paramount. It's so important. And for adults as well, when you feel like you can't communicate effectively at work because you just can't focus enough to do that. When you get to that point where you've exhausted a lot of different things, and even if you are working with somebody who's a coach or a therapist, that's going to help you. The medication may help you to grab those tools that mm-hmm. are being given to you a lot easier.
Right. You do a lot of work with adults.
Yes.
And that's what we're going to talk about this group here that's for adults with ADD. But is it something you've decided to figure out that you have as an adult, or do you always have it? I mean, you're born with this kind of condition.
70% of children move into adulthood with ADHD. So 70% of those that were diagnosed will carry that into adulthood. So it isn't something that magically goes away.
Right.
But if you have the tools at a younger age to get in control of the symptoms, that is something that can really help you as you get older.
We're going to take a break. I want to talk to you about what you do here at the Center for Learning Unlimited every week on Wednesday nights.
Yes.
You have a support group.
Yes.
Tell us about that group.
Okay, so my support group started 4 years ago. It was when, again, Carolyn Kelly came to me and asked me if I'd be willing to run an adult support group.
And she's with Chad, for the viewers watching that might know Carolyn.
She is with Chad, and she is the chairman of the board, and I'm on the board. There are a couple other people that are also on the board with us. And so I started this group 4 years ago with about three people in the group. And what I started to do is to share the mindfulness with everybody. I also started to share with them emotional, I like to call it emotional individuation, becoming individuated emotionally. Most of the people in our population are not grown up, the adults. We look grown up, but we don't act grown up. And so I put together—
Is that a bad thing?
You know what? It's a wonderful thing to be a child and to have fun, but when you're living in the real world and you're married and your wife or husband says, I feel like I have four children instead of three,
right.
That's when the time has come to become an adult.
Okay.
So the work that I did on myself, I share with everybody in the group. We do a lot of work, as I said before, with mindfulness, just teaching everyone about if you're in the moment, then a lot of your negative symptoms are going to go away. We have a lot of crosstalk that we do. We do reading. We use The Untethered Soul by Michael Singer, which is an incredible book for mindfulness. And we just started Byron Katie's book, Loving What Is. And this is just an amazing journey for everybody that's in this group.
So you've watched this group over 4 years grow, like you've grown, like you say, to up to 30 people come weekly.
Yes.
Why do you think that is? People are more comfortable to come and be part of a group?
I think the word has really gotten out that this group is a loving group. We have so much acceptance and love and trust that people with adults with attention deficit feel shame.
Mm-hmm.
And that's a horrible thing. So when they come to our group on Wednesday nights, they feel like they're just one of the group. And everybody accepts each other. We all reach out to each other and try to help each other in so many different ways. And it's not only myself. It's other people in the group. And afterwards, they exchange phone numbers. And it's just amazing when you put out that kind of feeling to people and make them feel acceptance for who they are, not what they do. That's an amazing feeling.
Mm-hmm. Well, you're an amazing woman, and I talked with some of your clients that are coming. We're going to take a break, and we are going to talk to some of these people that are coming to Justine's group every week. And after you hear their stories, you might be one of coming and join the group too. So stay tuned for that.
I met Justine originally as a life coach, and she had told me that she was doing this program, this weekly ADD support group. And I said, I don't have ADD, but I came anyways and discovered that I do have ADD. I always saw ADD as kids who couldn't pay attention in school, who were constantly on the move and on the go, couldn't, follow directions. And I didn't really see myself as that way. And once I learned that some of the symptoms that go along with having ADD or ADHD, I definitely had were prevalent in my life and were causing a little bit of chaos. Then I said, oh yeah, that's me, and I probably need to start working on these things. So, coming into the group, I'm able to throw out a problem I might be dealing with and get a lot of different suggestions on how to cope with that. And that is extremely helpful for me because just what one person may say, might not work for me. Some of the coping skills is not losing things, running on time, being able to focus, not hyper-focus, but focus on a task and follow it to completion, which is difficult.
Came here back in May of 2011, and what brought me here was probably a year before I'd heard about CHAAD, which is Children and Adults with ADD, and had procrastinated and was busy with so many other things, and I just kept on putting it off. And it was my wife who strongly encouraged me to do this, and it finally came to a head where she was, not making an ultimatum, but she was making it very clear, you got to do something, and she was right. So I called a good friend of mine, and he came with me the very first time, and been coming ever since. It's really been a great help for me. I had to gain self-awareness. And in that year that I was putting it off, I can say really was unaware. And so one of the first things that I think I learned in the CHAAD was how to become self-aware. And that's kind of been the start. And then to realize with ADHD, there's a number of, I say, symptoms or conditions that are very typical for people in our population. One is impulse control, the other one is time management, and the third one is emotional regulation. And if you're not self-aware, you're not in tune with any of those. And yet, I understood that things really weren't working for me. So starting from a place of growing self-awareness, what I'm learning in the group is a set of skills to be in control of my emotions and to, you know, recognize what are the things that kind of trigger reactions or trigger what we call the negative symptoms of ADHD.
Well, I've learned about the chat groups when I was up in Berkeley. I had gone to two of those up there. And so when I made my move from Berkeley to here, I looked for one here. This is a place where you feel felt. Everybody here is, how can I say, like you.
What were the issues you're trying to deal with in terms of, I don't know if you have ADD, ADHD, or what were you trying to work on?
Some time management skills, just being in the moment.
When did you realize, like, wow, I need to seek some support, I need some help, because, you know, the way you were functioning on a daily basis obviously wasn't serving you?
Possibly when I got to school, because in school is when I really started noticing that I couldn't focus, bad grades, everything like that. So that was the time I went and seeked psychological help. And so I got the help of a psychologist and a coach, and she helped me along to get better grades and stuff like that. So that's probably the time. The only thing I could say is try to stay in the moment, and whatever that means, different things to different people. For me, it means just become intensely aware of the present moment and don't engage in thought. So if you have a thought, or if you find yourself going on autopilot, moving on around, you have to first be self-aware of that. So it could take some time. But like I said, just take a deep breath, hold it in, let it out, and stay in the moment.
Talk about your center here, what the center does, what you're all about.
The Center for Learning Unlimited has been in our community for the last 11 years, and it was founded on the idea that there should be a resource in the community that serves children with complex neurological challenges.
One of your purposes here is weekly you have a program offered to the community where adults can come and attend a support group.
One of the premises when we started the Center for Learning Unlimited and the school, which is a non-public school and also WASC accredited, that's an unusual combination, was that we felt it was very important to help other not-for-profit agencies. And because I had a relationship with Justine and Carolyn Keller, then what we did is we said, when they came to me and said, we're looking for a new home, I said, please come and use this facility. It's very important that you have the landscape that you can grow.
Talk about how important the work is that's done through these weekly support groups, the impact you see that it has.
Oh, it changes lives. There's no doubt in my mind. I happen to have, unknown to Justine, several of the participants I've known, and they tell me that they don't know what they do without it. It makes such a remarkable difference for them as persons, and also them as an employee, as well as them as a family member. It truly makes a big difference. And I think that it's unusual because this program that is presented every single week cares and takes the time to get to know each of the participants. It's not just a lecture. It's not just a gathering. It's hard work that everyone does.
Justine, of course, after we listen to some of the clients that come every week and they love what you do, and I can understand why, we also spoke to the director of the Center for Learning Unlimited, where you're able to come here and hold your meetings. You have a nice relationship with
Virginia.
She's
wonderful. Yeah, Ginny is just wonderful. And if it wasn't for Ginny, and I tell her this all the time, well, this group wouldn't be as wonderful as it is, because she has donated this facility to us for free.
Right.
So that's amazing.
And again, your weekly group is 7 to 9:30 here, and it's practically free. It's for just a nominal donation.
Nominal donation. It's 7:30 to 9.
Oh, 7:30 to 9.
But I get here every week at 7, because I tell people, if you want to come early and talk to me, if you had a rough week and, you know, you need some extra little pushes and,
right,
you know, little mantras to make you feel positive, I'm here.
Because along with juggling the support group, you also are a life coach and you work your own private practice.
Yes, I have a private practice in Torrance, yes.
And so you're working with people with all different kinds of issues?
All different. Well, I basically stick in the world of ADD.
Mm-hmm.
And I
so
do
you're
a lot
not
of,
distracted.
Right, that's exactly right. I can stay focused. And I do a lot of family work, which I think is really, really important. I work with children, adolescents, adults, parents. I also do a lot of couple work, too.
Right. Yeah. The group, one more thing, it's really unique the way you do it here.
Yes,
you do.
Yes, it really is. It's very different than any other ADD support group that I'm aware of or have, you know, visited, because we do the work from the inside out. So just to give you an example, I had a gentleman call me about a year ago, and he really wanted me to help him get organized. He said, I have bought all these different things, and I need your help. And I said, you know what? I struggled with that myself. But until you do the work from the inside out, you can go to Staples and clean them out. All that stuff is going to be in your closet, and you're not going to work. It's not going to work for you. So it's really about understanding your own past schemas, because we have a lot of negative things that we've dealt with from the past, and the mindfulness stuff, and clearing out a lot of the bad feelings that we've had in the psyche and all that. That is so important, and then it all comes together. We get focused, and all those negative symptoms we are able to be in control of. So that's why the group is so different. We do spend times talking about, you know, little things that we do differently. Some people don't, what did you do this week so you could get this done? Because we all talk about things. So we'll have goals every week that we discuss too as well. But it's a very different group. And what I would like to talk about for a minute is CHAD itself. You know, CHAD is a wonderful organization, children and adults with ADD. And what we do here in the South Bay is we like to get as much information out to the people, because information is power. And every month, Carolyn, who's the chairman, she puts together a speaker series. And so the first Thursday of every month, we have professional people coming in and talking about all different things. We have psychiatrists, we have therapists, we have couples and relationship experts, we have people who can help you get organized, all these different people that come in. And it's just so wonderful because, again, that's a nominal fee, and you can just come in. And that starts at 6:45 on Thursdays, and it's at Little Company of Mary, the Educational Center. And it's just a wonderful place.
We'll give the website for CHAD. The CHAD's a national organization. This is the South Bay chapter.
Yes, so it's chad.org, and then you can actually navigate through to California and then the South Bay.
Okay.
Yes.
Well, we'll look forward to that, and we'll have to check out one of their programs. You do a lot of things. You multitask. You're an author as well.
Yes.
You've got a book that came out. Why don't we share that?
Yes.
ADD Land, written by Miss ADD. I love that.
So if you notice the cover, I'm going to explain to you how this happened. My very creative son designed this cover. So a couple of years ago, I was working with some young teenagers who were really, really kind of depressed with their diagnosis. And out of my creative mind came, you know what? There wouldn't be a Hollywood if it wasn't for ADD. And I saw their faces change. And so what I realized is I really needed to put this book together. And that's exactly what I did, because this book is all the very highly successful people, writers, entrepreneurs, musicians, actors. There's so many different
share
people
a few
in
names.
Here.
Just
so Walt Disney is in here. Steven Spielberg and John F. Kennedy Sr. and Jr. are both were diagnosed. And you know, it's just a really great book to see a little girl a couple of weeks ago, an 11-year-old, say, Mom, Elvis Presley has had ADD. So you know, they just feel like, wow. This is exciting. I can really have a wonderful life.
And right there on the cover, it says, the gift of ADD.
That's
and
exactly
and
right.
to turn it around so people think this as a gift and
yes.
not something that defines you as a negative label is important.
Absolutely. And that's where all the creative side, because every child, adolescent, adult that I work with, there is definitely a creative side. We are out of the box thinkers. We're not linear and progressive. So we don't go A, B, C, D, we go A, Z, and then we figure out how to get back. But it can be fun. And I tell parents all the time that the way they approach this is how their child is going to feel.
So ADD Land, the gift of ADD, is on Amazon?
Yes,
where
it
else
is.
Can people pick
and also
it up?
On my website, missadd.com. They can buy it from there.
Have you gotten some good feedback?
Yes, I have a lot of very positive feedback. People on Facebook have been writing me and telling me, you know, this is great, we need this, this is positive. So I'm excited about that.
For viewers that are watching right now that think, well, this sounds like me, like, what do you tell them? I mean, do you actually go take a test to get officially diagnosed, or what do you do?
Well, you know, diagnosis needs to come from a medical doctor, and I would suggest a psychiatrist, that they go see a psychiatrist and get, if they get diagnosed, then they can start doing the work. That doesn't necessarily mean that when they go to the psychiatrist, they have to initially take the medication. But my suggestion would be so that their life can be happier, they can feel good about themselves, that they decide to do something about it. And a start would be to come down to our support group on Wednesday nights, which I would love everybody to come, and we can be there for them and help them in any way. It's not such a negative thing. It can be a wonderful thing.
I like that you say it's a gift.
Yes, it is.
And your name is ADD. I asked you if there's a Mr. ADD, but...
Well, my husband is ADD because we're both ADD, so we have a lot of fun together.
And you personally, I mean, this is what you do. It's your life, but you must find challenges, too, every day to...
Absolutely. Yes, I do. It's not that it goes so smoothly for me. You know, I struggle every day with different types of challenges, but all the tools that I've given myself and I give to other people, I can use to actually pull myself back to center, as I like to call that.
Okay, yeah. I like mindfulness.
Yes, mindfulness is great.
Well, we really, again, appreciate you spending the time.
Thank you.
And thanks for all the work you're doing, and we hope you've helped some viewers out there. Again, your website's missadd.com.
Correct.
Thank you. I'm going to wrap this edition of Around the Peninsula. I'm Liz Brown Swanson. Thank you for joining us. See you next time, and thanks for paying attention.